Hi dear students, in this video I am going to discuss about liquefaction of gases. This is from the chapter states of matter. Liquefaction of gases. Liquefaction of gases. Students, gases can be converted into liquids under the following conditions. Gases can be converted into liquids under the following conditions. They are low temperature, high pressure. Low temperature, high pressure is required. Students, in order to convert into the CO2 gas into the CO2 liquid, the temperature should be, it should be less than the 30.98 degrees Celsius. Temperature definitely it should be less than the 30.98 degrees Celsius. If CO2 is present above this temperature, it cannot be converted into liquid even if you increase the pressure more. And the pressure should be, this is about the temperature, temperature should be greater than, lesser than 30.98 degrees. Pressure should be more than the 73 atmospheres. Then only CO2 gas can be converted. It should satisfy both the conditions. Temperature should be less than 30.98 and the pressure should be greater than 73 atmosphere. This is a minimum pressure required for the liquefaction of CO2. This temperature is called as critical temperature. Every gas has a different critical temperatures, right? So high value of critical temperature indicates that is having high intermolecular forces of attraction, and A value will be more. Then here, to convert the CO2 gas into the liquid CO2, the temperature should be less than 30.98 and pressure is greater than the 73 atmospheres. Now let us discuss about the critical temperature. Critical temperature indicated with the TC. Critical temperature is indicated with the TC. The temperature, above which gas cannot be converted into liquid even at high pressure. TC, it is indicated as TC, critical temperature is 8A by 27 RB. Students, already we have discussed that A value will depends on the intermolecular forces of attraction. As the intermolecular forces of attraction is high, A value will be more, right? As the A value is more, TC will be more, right? TC, we can write it as a critical temperature is directly proportional to A, which is directly proportional to the intermolecular forces. Intermolecular forces of attraction, it is present, right? So, for example, students, if they have given A, B, C, D, four gases is given. And if it is given TC values for the A, it is 30 degrees Celsius. B given as minus 15 degrees Celsius. C given as 60 degrees Celsius and D is given as minus 65 degrees Celsius. If they are asking these gases to arrange in the increasing ease of liquefaction, increasing ease of liquefaction, which is easier to liquefy, is the gas which has a more temperature, it is easy to convert into the liquid. Okay, increasing ease of the liquefaction. Then which is the least, which has a least critical temperature, that is very difficult to liquefy. D, then B, then which is B is less than A, and with the highest critical temperature 60 degrees C is easier to liquefy. This is the order of ease of liquefaction for the given gases. Students, now let us discuss about the critical pressure. Critical pressure. Critical pressure indicated with the PC. Critical pressure is indicated with PC. The minimum pressure, it is defined as the minimum pressure required to liquefy a gas, it is a minimum pressure required to liquefy a gas. PC is given by a formula A by 27 B square. It is a minimum pressure required, student. If the pressure is less than the PC, gas cannot be converted into the liquid state. Even temperature may be low, pressure should be minimum. It is equal to the critical pressure. Critical volume. Critical volume. VC, indicated with the VC. The volume of 1 mole of gas at critical temperature and critical temperature and critical pressure. VC is given by a formula 3B. We know B is a van der Waals constant, which is known as co-volume. Now students, let us discuss about the Andrews isotherm. Andrews isotherms, which will explain the importance of critical temperature. Andrews isotherms for the CO2 gas. Isotherms means the P versus V graphs at the constant temperature is called as isotherms. By taking volume on the x-axis, pressure on the y-axis, we'll get a graph like this. This region indicates gas plus liquid. This is a graph at 13.1 degree Celsius, 21.5 degree Celsius, 30.98 degree Celsius, 20.98 degree Celsius. Students, I am making a rough diagram for the Andrews isotherms. When the temperature is slightly greater than this, that is at 31 degree Celsius, this is at 31 degree Celsius, this graph is at 30.98 degree Celsius, This region indicates gas state. This region, this is a pressure which is equal to 73 atmospheres. Above this pressure only CO2 exists as a liquid state. Students, for example, we will take the first graph, 13.1 degree Celsius. In the reverse, you observe this is bottom to top pressure values are increasing. Bottom to top pressure values are increasing. As the pressure increases, here for first graph you see, as the pressure increases, the volume starts decreasing. Here in this right to the left, volume is decreasing. Pressure increasing, volume decreases, it will decreases. There is a sudden drastic decrease in the volume because gas is started converted into the liquid at this condition, right, at this point. Here both will exist in this region, gas plus liquid both will exist. This region is for the gas. And 13.1 degree Celsius, as the pressure increases, volume decreases, volume is decreasing. But when it is starts converting into the liquid, there is a drastic decrease in the volume. And then it is converted into the liquid state, that is above 73 atmospheres. 73 atmospheres. When we observe this for the 21.5 degree Celsius, which is slightly greater than this temperature, this region is very less. Gas plus liquid region is less. Whereas in the case of 30.98 degree Celsius, it will just enter into this liquid and gas state at a certain point only, and immediately it will convert into the liquid state. Completely it is converted into the liquid state. It is slightly greater than this temperature, 31 degree Celsius. Even if you increase the pressure, it won't convert into the liquid state. It will remains as a gas only, because here the critical temperature of CO2 gas is 30.98. that is the importance of the critical temperature. And above this critical pressure only gas can be converted into liquid. Temperature should be less than the its critical temperature, right? For the CO2, TC value from this graphs 30.98 degree Celsius, and pressure PC is equal to 73 atmospheres. It is possible to convert a gas, CO2 gas, into the liquid. Temperature should be less than this. Pressure should be minimum of 73 atmospheres. Students, this is all about the liquefaction of gases. Thanks for watching.